This episode is sponsored by Brilliant. From ripples in the sand to the stripes on a zebra, all the way down to the sodium and chlorine atoms in a crystal of salt, repeating patterns in nature remind us how even the most chaotic systems can produce their own form of order. While the patterns we see around us are cool to look at, things become very interesting when we go down to the atomic level. The combination of these patterns and quantum mechanical effects give rise to the beautiful colors we see in butterfly wings, peacock feathers, and the way a chameleon changes color when it's excited. In this video, we're going to see the exact quantum physics involved and how our chameleon Bernard here uses it to his advantage to find love, or at least to woo a girl chameleon. To understand this, we first have to understand this salt crystal. If we zoom into the atomic level, we see a very neat and periodic arrangement of atoms with electrons orbiting around them. This structure is called a crystal lattice because it's common to all crystals. Now, the key idea is that these electrons can't have just any energy level. Okay guys, things are about to get real. This is the infamous Schrödinger wave equation, and it's kind of the holy grail of quantum physics. I did a whole video about it. But quickly, this equation tells us everything we can possibly know about a quantum particle, like an electron. Now, this funny looking pitchfork here is the Greek letter psi, and it stands for what's called the wave function of the electron. See, electrons are a bit elusive in that you can't pinpoint exactly where they are, like regular objects. You can only predict where they might be with more or less probability. This probability is modeled by a wave, hence the name wave function. Now the thing is, only certain wavelengths can exist in a confined space. If you imagine a string on a guitar, only certain wavelengths are allowed because the ends need to be attached to the guitar. For example, this wavelength is fine, but this one doesn't work. This one is fine, this one, nope. That's why two strings of different length can't produce the same sounds. It's the same thing going on with our electrons in the crystal lattice. Only certain wave functions are allowed, while others are banished, because of the fixed lengths within the lattice. The energy of an electron is intrinsically linked to its wave function. So if only certain wave function values are allowed, only certain energy levels are allowed. And indeed, when we solve the Schrödinger equation, that's exactly what we get. This equation gives us the energy levels allowed for an electron. Notice how all the terms are constant values except one. H bar is Planck's constant on 2π. M is the mass of the electron, which doesn't change. L is the length of the lattice spacing, which doesn't change, and pi is a constant. N is the only value that changes and needs to go up in whole numbers. Therefore, if N can only increase in whole numbers and the rest of the values are fixed, the energy levels must also increase in discrete chunks. But what's the point of all this math if it doesn't result in a happy chameleon? These calculations apply to just one particle. But things get pretty interesting when we have a party of particles. The periodic structure of the crystal lattice means the atoms are really close together. So the electrons are all whizzing around and interacting, and their energy levels start overlapping, blurring into kind of energy bands. These energy bands and the gaps between them decide which electron energies are and are not allowed inside the crystal. Now let's imagine everything blown up 100 or 200 times. Instead of atoms, say we have some periodic structure, and instead of electrons, we have particles of light, photons. It turns out that similar band structures appear when we have microscopic patterns which have a period in the range of the wavelength of visible light. These are called photonic crystals because of their similarity to regular crystals. This structure leads to the formation of optical bands, just like electronic bands, which allow some wavelengths of light to pass and others to get reflected. This makes objects appear a certain color, and different structures allow for different colors. Now you might be wondering, how is this different from regular colors? How is it going to help our boy Bernard here impress his date? The big difference is that with photonic crystals, the color is dependent on the structure of the material, while the regular colors that we see around us are dependent on the chemical composition of the material. Take leaves, for example. Leaves look green because the electrons in the shaded region of the chlorophyll molecule get excited when light hits them, and due to their chemical bonding, they absorb blue and red light and reflect green. Fun fact, if you ever want to grow plants inside and use indoor lighting, try using a purple light. Purple is a mixture of blue and red, which the plants need to grow. Shining green light on leaves does little to their growth because it's reflected and wastes energy. So purple light is energy efficient for plant growth. So that's how color usually works. But in photonic crystals, the color comes from the interaction of light with the physical structure of the material, not the chemical bonds. Take, for example, this CD. Now, I don't know if this is considered vintage these days, but it's basically something that plays music. Notice the beautiful colors that we have. The multicolor pattern isn't caused by a colorful coating. It happens because of the underlying pattern or tracks where the data is written. The track spacing is comparable to the wavelengths of visible light. And so different wavelengths of different light diffract at different angles, giving multicolor patterns. Chameleons, butterfly wings, and peacock feathers all have photonic crystals in them. And these microscopic interactions manifest themselves in a pretty cool way at the macroscopic level. For one thing, the color can be tuned. Chameleons change their body color by adjusting the crystal patterns to indicate when they're excited. By stretching or compressing the lattice, they can change the color of light which is reflected, going from a dull camouflage to a vibrant hue. And what girl wouldn't be impressed by that? Another cool thing is that photonic crystals reflect different colors depending on the angle you look at them. This is why you see those cars that go from green to purple as you walk by them. They have special paint with photonic crystals. Today, lots of research is being done to mimic the biophotonic crystals found in nature for a range of applications from camouflaging and even optical communication. In fact, one of the main technologies of solar energy, solar panels, use the same physics of structural color we find in Barnard and peacocks. By engineering the thickness of the glass layer, we can control what colors of light are reflected and absorbed, just like Barnard. This is an interactive cartoon from today's sponsor, Brilliant.org. You can adjust the wavelength of light and the thickness of the glass to control which colors are reflected. Then use what you've learned to answer today's problem about creating anti-reflexive coating in a solar panel. If you find that this excites in you a passion for solar energy, you can talk about it with the other engineers discussing the problem, or check out a whole course about it. This is just one of Brilliant's daily problems, which range from vector calculus to computational biology to quantum physics, and every problem has an accompanying course to go with it. Signing up is free, but I strongly recommend their premium membership, which gives you unlimited access to all their courses. I use Brilliant pretty much every day to deepen my understanding about the video topic I'm working on. I've used it for a bunch of my quantum physics videos and pretty much whenever I need to brush up on math, and I find it to be an invaluable tool. For a 20% discount, be one of the first 200 people to sign up using this link, which is in the description of this video. Just go to brilliant.org/upandatom. Okay, bye.